nama saya Edwin Elia. Saya software engineer di Google Cloud, data analytics, and cloud data fusion product. Saya masuk ke Google melalui acquisition dari startup namanya Cast Data. Cast Data dibeli Google tahun lalu, dan produk itu baru-baru di launch di Google Cloud namanya Cloud Data Fusion. Dan produk itu adalah big data pipeline creation that is UI driven. Jadi semuanya kalau mau bikin data pipeline, mau pindahin data dari database 1 ke database 2, bisa pakai UI aja, nggak perlu coding. So it's a UI driven data pipeline. Google is a very innovative culture. Di Google ada konsep namanya 20% project. Jadi 20% jam saya bisa dipakai untuk passion project saya. Mau bikin produk baru, atau mau ngetes satu fitur, atau mau cobain kerja di tim lain. Jadi di Google Cloud or Google in general, mereka kasih space and time and resources buat kita ngetes ide-ide baru. Banyak support di Google buat sebagai developer kita bisa terus berkembang. Banyak kelas-kelas, dan kelas-kelasnya nggak cuma kelas untuk development, ada juga kelas consulting, atau kalau kita mau kerja lebih dekat ke customer, bisa training public speaking, atau mau belajar masak juga ada. Jadi banyak support-support atau kelas-kelas dan bagian-bagian lain yang bisa dicobain di Google, yang nggak sebenarnya bukan pekerjaan utama saya. The number one thing that I noticed that is amazing in Google, it's their postmortem culture. Postmortem is a culture where once a mistake happens, the blame is never on the person. Jadi saya sebagai developer, sebagai pekerja di Google, merasa safe buat make a mistake and push my boundaries. I'm never afraid that if I make a mistake, I'm going to get fired the next day by my manager. But instead, we blame the system. Kenapa sistemnya bisa nggak safe sampai kejadian ini bisa terjadi? Itu misalnya YouTube goes down gitu. Itu bukan cari oh salah siapa. No, we think about how was the system organized in such a way that accident happened, and let's come up with a way to prevent it from happening again. Jadi selalu kita bikin report kalau ada kejadian kayak begini, bikin report kejadiannya apa yang terjadi, steps buat benerinnya apa aja, dan action item abis itu mesti apa yang perlu dirubah supaya kejadian ini nggak terjadi lagi. Tapi nggak pernah, it's always blameless, it's never pointing fingers. I think that's really amazing, and that creates mental safety inside Google, that as an engineer I can push my boundaries, I can keep developing without worry that I might get fired or be afraid of doing certain things. Yeah. In Indonesian startup ecosystem, number one, it's already pretty interesting because they are considered a cloud native ecosystem. Nggak ada lagi biasanya startup yang beli server, bikin server farm sendiri, tapi mereka langsung ke go to cloud. Dan ini membantu banget karena kalau misalnya bisnisnya terus bertumbuh, nggak terhambat dari butuh beli server, butuh upkeep with a new software, tapi bisa langsung scale up dari cloud provider saja. I think in general the ecosystem support system in Indonesia is still developing. It's the stigma to startups also changing. So I think moving forward is just having more ecosystem, more investors, more users, and especially talent pool. I think from talking to a few startup co-founders in Indonesia, they're struggling to find talents. But as startup becomes becoming more popular, more successful, more and more talents will be willing to work for a startup, or they want to study about more technical things, more IT related stuff. Jadi lebih banyak orang yang lebih banyak software engineers di Indonesia yang bisa support the ideas of these entrepreneurs that are already kind of booming in Indonesia.